senso unico, non possiamo più andare.
Mi sembra veramente...
Gut.
Thank you.
Tuesday.
Exactly.
Brilliant. Okay. I guess the first question is, obviously this is a very starry Venice. It's always very starry. How do you feel about attracting some of the world's biggest stars to Venice?
Well, it comes with the good things, in the sense that Venice is back again. It's conceived again as an ideal launching platform for big films. And when you have the chance to make a strong selection, having a strong lineup, the talents are there that comes with the film. So, and this year it's true that we have a lot of big names, big talents, big stars, especially from American cinema, but not only, of course.
I mean, Venice has always sort of been seen now as the launchpad for Oscar contenders as well. And you've personally sort of said that you think the Joker stands a good chance. Why do you think that?
But you will see the film. When you see the film, you will realize that it's something very special. It's not just a part of the Batman saga. It's not a spin-off of Dark Knight. This is the start of the film. But then the film becomes something else, much more ambitious. It's a very dark movie, very sad movie again, with a strong character in the center. It's a film about our contemporary society, about the problem we live in a big city. It's an astonishing, ambitious film.
With these festivals, one of the things that seems to be coming up in the last few years are distributors like Netflix. The UNIC sort of asked that you didn't show any films at the festival that weren't going to have a theatrical release. What are your personal feelings about that?
This is a specific situation in France because of the law they have about the windows between theatrical release and the streaming. We don't have this kind of problem in Italy, and most of the festivals of the world, like Berlin, Locarno, Toronto, Sundance, they're going to invite film produced by the streamers more and more in the future. So we opened the road in a way 4 years ago, or 5 years ago, I forgot, inviting the first film by Netflix in competition. Netflix now is part of the American Association of the Film Producers, so there is no difference between Netflix and the major studios in Hollywood anymore.
But your view would still be watching movies on a big screen if you can.
Of course, this is the best experience you can have, watching a movie. And I do hope that Netflix will accept to have a theatrical release for the great movie they are going to produce in the future.
One of the other things that people are talking about this year is that there's only two female directors in the competition. I know that you're personally opposed to quotas, but is there a step that the festival's taking to kind of try and get more women to submit their films?
Well, you know, this year we got something like 2,000 submissions. 23% of the submissions were films made by women. We have in our line now 25% of the film produced signed by women. So this is the average of film production today. It's true, we have only two films in the main competition. It's a matter of, how can I say, the quality of the film itself. The only criteria we use in selecting a film is the quality of the film. I'm sure that the situation is going to change quite fast in the next few years, but it takes time because there's still a strong prejudice in the film industry against the talent and the creativity of the women, but it's going to change. I'm sure about that.
Another controversial filmmaker is here this year, or his film is here this year, Roman Polanski.
Yeah.
Was there any kind of doubt in your mind about whether to include his film in the selection?
No, I have to be clear about that. When I saw the film, I thought it was a great movie by one of the last masters of the European cinema. I don't have any doubt about the idea to invite the film in competition. I'm not a judge. I'm not in position to decide if it is right or wrong to put Polanski in jail. I'm a film critic, and the only way to deal with this kind of situation is to try to understand if the film is good enough to be invited to a festival.
Just finally, what are you most personally excited about for this year's festival?
The Well, you know, this is a wonderful combination of well-established filmmakers and a lot of newcomers, new talents, discoveries. The lineup of the festival is full of uncovered gems that we hope will get the attention from both the critics and the audience in the festival.
Brilliant. Thank you so much. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a great